I am Milay Kumar, working as an assistant professor, Department of Physics, St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science. Dear students, in this session, I am going to explain the Millikan's experiment, how to verify the Einstein's photoelectric equation. Millikan's experiment, verification of Einstein's photoelectric equation. We may split up into three parts for explaining this experiment. First one, construction. Alkali metals, sodium, lithium, and potassium are employed as emitters. Since they exhibit photoelectric emission even with visible light. So next, there is a glass block G. So inside the glass block G, we kept a sodium, potassium and lithium are mounted on a spindle S. The spindle can be rotated from outside by an electromagnet. As each metal block passes by a adjustable sharp edge, capital K, a thin layer of it is removed. Thus, exposing a fresh surface of the metal to the irradiating light entering the flux through a quartz window W. The flux is evacuated to a very high vacuum to free the metals from all absorbed gases. Monochromatic light provided by a spectroscope, which is used to illuminate the fresh metal surfaces. The photoelectrons are collected by the cylinder named as Faraday cylinder. Then, working about the Millikan's experiment. The Millikan's experiment is purely based on the stopping potential. So what is meant by stopping potential? The stopping potential V of the photoelectrons is measured by raising the emitter surface to a positive potential. V is the positive potential applied to the emitter, which corresponds to zero current in the electrometer. Potential V is determined for varying the different wavelengths of the incident light also. The value of V should be corrected for any contact potential between the metal C and Faraday cylinder F. So through this procedure, finally we calculate the H value, which agrees fairly well with the value obtained by other methods also. Theory about the Millikan's experiment. Stopping potential is the principle through which the Millikan's experiment works. So what is meant by stopping potential? It is a retarding potential difference required in order to just halt the most energetic photoelectron emitted. the kinetic energy of a photoelectron leaving the surface of the metal is given by half mv square, which is equal to h nu minus pi. So capital B be the potential difference which is applied between the emitter and a collecting electrode in order to prevent the photoelectron, so that we can equate the potential difference to kinetic energy. That means EV equal to half mv square. So EV, which is equal to h nu minus pi, or we can write as capital B equal to h by E nu minus pi by E, which represents the equation 1. Here h, which represents the Planck's constant, and pi is a constant for a given metal. The equation 1 represents a straight line. So now we can draw the graph between the stopping potential and frequency. From the graph we can find out the straight line which is observed between the stopping potential and frequency. So find out the slope of the straight line. From the slope we can find out the tan theta value, which is equal to h by e. H equal to e tan theta, equation 2. So through this expression we will find out the value for h. H can be calculated. The intercept on the x-axis gives the threshold frequency, which is mentioned by nu naught. So from this, photoelectric work function pi equal to h nu naught is calculated. Then substituting the known value of E, h is calculated. The value of h calculated in this agrees fairly well with the value obtained by other methods. Finally, we conclude that the Einstein's equation can be verified experimentally.